According to the officials from the Ministry of Water and Environment, it's very dangerous for people to interfere with water bodies such as wetlands, lakeshores, riverbanks and swamps for settlement, farming and other activities. Their wish is to see encroachers vacate peacefully before being pushed out in order to preserve the wetlands, protect the ecosystem and keep water clean.
We have cut down the tree cover and we are relying heavily. You find that many of the areas, they are relying on rain-fed agriculture. You just do plant without irrigation. You are next to the river. You have got your crops drying. You are getting low yields, but you are just next to the river. We knowingly or unknowingly, we have waged war. I can say we have waged war on wetlands by clearing wetlands, and these wetlands are actually the ones which can actually absorb this excessive surface runoff.
Engineer Christopher Tumsime, the Commissioner of Water Utility Regulation Department at the Ministry of Water and Environment, also expressed worry over the deteriorating water quality because of the uncontrolled pollutants that are discharged in large quantities of untreated waste, sewage dumping of industrial waste, heavy metals, among others, that all end up in water bodies.
Water has deteriorated both in quality and quantity. Quality because, if I tell you, our service provider in this country here in Kampala, National Water and Sewage Corporation, who are pumping from Gaba, we keep increasing the cost of treating this water. The cost of treatment goes up, keeps going up, simply because of the inflow of whatever comes out of Kampala into the lake. And for that matter, we had, even as National Water and Sewage Corporation, to shift the bigger treatment plant from here because of the contamination, and we had to go to Katosi to look for a virgin area which still has got tree cover.
To partly tackle these challenges, the Ministry of Water and Environment has organized the second Appropriate Technologies Exhibition to showcase a wide range of technologies that can be adopted to save the environment.
We are going to have it from 2nd to 4th of February, and it will provide us with an opportunity to learn about the technologies that can be used to foster sustainable water supply and groundwater development management, sustainable sanitation management, sustainable clean energy, food security and nutrition, health, lives and wellness, climate smart technologies, and natural resources management.
Story by Jaliet Namwaya for the news.